In this video, I want to talk about a property of real numbers called the multiplication property that can really help us when we're trying to solve linear equations. It goes something like this. It says, if A equals B, and these are expressions, if A equals B, then for any value of n, if you multiply the left-hand side by n and multiply the right-hand side by n, the equality is maintained. And so you can think of this like a scale where we're weighing one side against another. And we start off with an equal scale. A is equal to B, so this is exactly flat and horizontal. One's not heavier than the other. But for example, if you doubled the weight of the left-hand side, and that's all you did, the left-hand side would go down and the right-hand side would go up, and they would not be equal anymore. So to maintain this equality, you would have to also double the right-hand side. But that's not true just with doubling both sides. You could triple both sides. And as long as you tripled both sides equally, then the equality would be maintained. And so this is a property that is, like I said, extremely helpful when we're trying to solve linear equations. So let me run through a few examples with you, and we'll try a couple. Let's say, for example, we had x divided by 4 equals 3. So some number divided by 4 equals 3, and I would love to solve for x. Well, let me ask us, what is done to x? Well, x is being divided by 4. So a good thing to do would be to multiply the left-hand side by 4. And the reason that's a good idea is, what happens when you multiply something by 4 and divide something by 4? Then these will cancel each other and you'll just be left with x. And so that'll help us solve for x. But just multiplying the left side by 4 is not allowed. We would not have equality, and we would not still maintain our equality here between that and 3. So if you want to multiply the left-hand side by 4, totally fine. But we also have to multiply the right-hand side by 4 as well, so that we're increasing them proportionately. 3 times 4 gives us 12. And so we would get x equals 12. We can go back and see if that's correct. X divided by 4 should have been 3. 12 divided by 4 is 3. So this is, in fact, the right answer. All right, let's maybe try one more. Let's say we had, negative 5y equals 20. Negative 5y equals 20. Negative 5 times what number would give us 20? Well, here, y is being multiplied by 5. And so just like the multiplication property, there's also the division property. You can divide both sides by the same amount and get the same equivalency between the terms, as long as you do it fairly on both sides. So since y is times negative 5, if we'd like to just have a y, if we'd like to solve for y, let's divide the left-hand side by negative 5. What will happen is these negative 5s will cancel. Times negative 5 and divided by negative 5 will cancel, or give us times 1 in effect. And so we'll get y equals what? Well, if we divided the left-hand side by negative 5, to be fair, we need to also divide the right side by negative 5, because if we don't, this won't stay an equal symbol. And 20 divided by negative 5, of course, is negative 4. So if we look back at the original problem, if y was equal to negative 4, let's see what we get. Negative 5 times negative 4, sure enough, is positive 20. So this would be the solution to the equation here. Now, you could even think of this, even this example, as the multiplication property. You could think of it like this. Let's say we had negative 5y equals 20. Instead of saying divide by negative 5, you could say multiply by negative 1/5. That would basically be the same thing. And so when these cancel, you would also get y equals negative 4, the exact same answer that we got back here.